The Isaiah Thomas Citizen of the Year Award is given to a person in central Massachusetts who has made an outstanding contribution to society during the year or for services rendered throughout a period of time. The original Isaiah Thomas Award for Distinguished Community Service was created in 1950 by the Ad Club of Greater Worcester. It has been combined with the Telegrama Gazette's Vision Citizen of the Year Award. This year, the award goes to Dr. Abraham W. Haddad. Whether it stemmed from his upbringing as one of six children by immigrant parents or his intense focus on collaboration, one thing is for sure. Abe Haddad knows how to get things done. He came to Worcester in 1971 for a residency at the former Memorial Hospital, but then left for 3 years of specialty training at Tufts University School of Dental Medicine. Yet he couldn't get Worcester out of his blood. He was lured back by the prospect of the establishment of a dental school for UMass, which never really got off the ground. But based on his previous experience and the positive influence of people at Memorial, he decided to stay. He became chairman of the Division of Dental Medicine through the latter part of the 1970s and served in that capacity through the 80s. That program then closed due to cost-cutting measures, but it exposed him to the unmet needs in the areas of geriatric dentistry and the treatment of patients with specific developmental problems. And it became his introduction into the world of community volunteerism. While working at places like Family Health Center and Great Brook Valley, he found himself being recruited to serve on other boards in the community. And so began a journey in which, by his own account, he has logged about 15,000 hours of community service since those first years in Worcester. He's been involved in the Greater Worcester Community Foundation, the Worcester County Music Association, the Worcester Economic Club, the Worcester Art Museum, and the American Heart Association, to name a few. He jokes that it's his wife, Linda, who holds the secret as to why he serves on so many community and civic boards. It's not that he carefully selects which ones he belongs to, rather, she claims it's his ability to just say no. But in addition to his willingness to get involved, it could also be an intense interest in innovation that drives him. Those who know Abe say they often hear him ask, "What's new? What's next?" It undoubtedly was that mindset that set him on the course for which he may be best known. Abe and Bill Short, then president of the Worcester Regional Chamber of Commerce, were co-chairs of the effort that led to the successful development of the Massachusetts Biotechnology Research Park. The initiative involved securing state land off Plantation Street for construction of research buildings, passing local regulations, permitting specific research, and launching an economic development agency to nurture startup companies. That agency still exists as Massachusetts Biomedical Initiatives, and Abe is its chairman of the Board of Trustees. He divides his time between his office and MBI's space at Gateway Park and his former periodontal practice, which he sold last year. He says he has little interest in retiring, but is using more time to be with his wife, children, and grandchildren, and to pursue his love of sailing. And now I would like to turn your attention to the large screen.
Co-chair of the Long Range Planning Committee out of the chamber. What I love about him is that he's not complacent. He doesn't sit on his hands. He's not satisfied. He always wants to look into the future. He's got a great knack for being able to get people together. Because people like him, and they know he's going to get things done and pull people together. And I think that's a key ingredient, and also a key ingredient to success in this community tied to his efforts.
Congratulations, Abe, on being honored for your noteworthy accomplishments, which have greatly benefited Worcester's growth and enhanced its image. It took determination and perseverance for you to make things happen, and I personally witnessed those attributes while working with you during your tenure as president of Music Worcester many years ago. Remember the Nureyev saga? Wow, such great memories, Abe.
Abe is a tremendous leader. When he learned from Senator Chandler that there were major problems with care for the needy in the community, he challenged the Worcester Community Democrat to come up with solutions to fix those problems. He knows everybody. He understands the issues like nobody I know. And he is not going to settle for just a band-aid on a major problem.
I've had the pleasure of working with Abe over a long period of time. And, you know, he's distinctive in many ways. The word that comes to mind in describing him is resolute. Abe is one of the most resolute people I know, which is to say that if Abe resolves to get something done, it will get done. There is a secret sauce in all of us. The secret sauce in Abe is single-minded pointedness towards getting something done. And I guess you call that effectiveness. Abe is a very, very effective leader, and I congratulate him.
Abe Hatton is a remarkable man. I've known him for a long time, but it wasn't until about 12 years ago that I went to him and said, "We really have a problem with oral health. Can you help me?" And in his own unique way, he put together a group of people and we started to make a difference with oral health in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. He's an incredible juggler of his time, his energy. He's a hugely compassionate person, and I'm proud to call him my friend.
Abe, your devotion to family, tradition, values has been an inspiration to me. We get many calls from people asking for help, and this could be medical, dental, social, community, and anything else. And you say yes, because no is not in your vocabulary. You have touched many lives and you continue to do it. Congratulations. A hug to my Energizer bunny.
Civic pride and responsibility, his exceptional public service, and his spirit of innovation, the Telegram and Gazette is honored to present the 2012 Visions Isaiah Thomas Award to Dr. Abraham W. Hatton.
Thank you all for coming. I want to thank my family, my daughter Kimberly, my son William, who gave me the time to be able to pursue these activities, which have given me more satisfaction than any amount of money or material things could have provided. In closing, I would like to remember my mother and father who worked tirelessly and unselfishly in order that their six children be afforded the opportunity to pursue an education, not only for the purpose of becoming a professional, but also for the love of knowledge itself. I especially want to thank my wife, Linda, who has been my advisor, partner, soulmate, and throughout many years, my best companion. Thank you.